What is long and hard and full of bamboo references? Behave by Robert Sapolsky. I can't think of any other book where you can learn more about human behavior than this one. This book, it's quite a brick. It gives a great overview of why we humans behave as we do. It's a collection of years, decades of research. One is called Behave, the Biology of Humans at Our Best and Our Worst. Today I wanted to share some notes and some highlights from this book. It took me a while to read this one. And it talks about human behavior and it dissects it. It's like why, what happens like in the body, what are those chemical processes the second before we do something, the minute we do for something, the hours before something. What are the evolutionary background to our behaviors? Why can we be so kind and selfless and at the same time be a savage beast almost? And this is an exciting story about what makes us human. Frontal cortex, or I have no idea where it sits. It's what makes us do the harder thing when it's the right thing to do. The frontal cortex, though, that prevents us from doing a lot of stupid and impulsive stuff, it's consuming a lot of energy. And you probably notice that as the day progresses, your willpower goes down. Like what was easy to ignore earlier in the day becomes harder. Maybe you're one of us who make much worse food decisions later in the day, for instance. And maybe you have noticed how you're much more quick to judge and how hard it is to just be a good person when you're sleep deprived or you're tired from a day's of work. Initially, demanding frontal tasks becomes easier with time. Remember when we were kids, or if you have kids, you've probably seen it quite recently, like it's hard like just to control our bladder. But we need to understand that repeated good behavior makes it become habitual, automatic, and it takes much less effort. But we also habituate in many, many other ways. I mean, take all the artificial pleasures that we have these days, like highly processed food that tastes like and then we have VR porn, we have drugs. All of these things, they threw our system off, basically. And we make it gives us a hard time to appreciate those things that are natural. I have an example. I have a friend that eats never, he doesn't have the best like a diet, so to speak. And when he eats a salad, like it's unbelievable for him because like it tastes like nothing compared to like all the highly processed food. And you probably have examples like that from your own life. One uniquely human thing is to delay gratifications. There's actually no other animal in the animal kingdom that does this. Like there's no other animal that cut calories for 3 months just to be able to look nice at the beach during like the 2 weeks of summer we have here in Sweden. Quote, "The opposite of love is not hate, it's indifference." One interesting thing that this book talks about is alcohol as well. This common belief that alcohol triggers aggressive behavior. But and that's a theme that keeps coming back in this book. Like it's not as simple as we would like it to be. Things are very complex. If I had to say one word about this book's a summary, it would be, well, it's complicated. Because the thing is, like, alcohol does not make you aggressive, but alcohol makes people who already have a tendency towards aggressiveness become more aggressive. And it's the same thing with other substances like testosterone. It makes people who are already by nature aggressive more aggressive, but testosterone enhances any behavior that helps us maintain our status. So it's not as straightforward as like sometimes I want things to be. There is this famous study among, I think they were on judges, and they were looking at the judgments that were passed depending on what time of day, if the judges were hungry or not. And there was this quite scary statistic that came from this, and it is that people who were being judged or being taken to court right before lunch when the judge was hungry. They got much harsher sentences than right after lunch. And this is a small thing, but it's a big takeaway for me because I try to use stuff like this. Maybe at a smaller scale, like not in life and death situations, but if, let's say, if I'm going to go to my boss and ask for a raise, if you learn stuff like this from this book, you have an advantage because I won't book my meeting right before lunch, right? That would be stupid because then he would be grumpy or she would not be in the mood or as open to ideas like this as if this person would be right after lunch. And I was thinking to myself, and this is probably one of my main takeaways, is that as we read and learn from books like this, we learn about human nature, evolutionary psychology, all of that, and start to use this in our lives. It would be interesting to see like how much of an advantage it actually becomes over a lifetime. Like it's small tweaks like that, like knowing when is a good time to ask for something, knowing about how alcohol triggers different behaviors in different people. Like knowing all of these things, we could be much more strategic in how we approach life situations with other people's relationships, all of that. And it probably adds up to a big difference compared to if we wouldn't read books like this. And I think that's one of the important to pick up, like serious nonfiction books like this one. It's thick, but there's so much benefit to learning these things. I promise myself this is not going to be a long video, so I'm going to wrap this up now. And this book, it's a very, very detailed and nuanced summary of where we're at and what we know about human behavior. And this is definitely worth picking up if this is your thing. It's a thick one, it's intimidating, but it's well worth the effort. See you next week with more books. And click the subscribe button, the bell, all of that. Leave a comment, and it would definitely help me reach more people with good books like this one.